Hi everyone, Copilot Pages is finally here. This is a new capability which is part of the Copilot Wave 2. You can now edit Copilot results in a loop page. You can brainstorm, create content for your project, generate documents, and cover many scenarios. A loop page that you create using Copilot Pages is dropped in SharePoint Embedded. It's important to know that when the account of the user is deleted, the content stored in the container in SharePoint Embedded is deleted as well. So keep in mind that. And if you want to disable this new capability in your organization, you can do that in three different ways. Let me show you everything in this video preview about Copilot Pages. Let's go. And here I am in the main dashboard of Microsoft 365, M365 Cloud, Microsoft or Office.com. Before to dive into Copilot Pages, let me talk about how you can disable this feature, because probably you want to run an adoption and training campaign before rolling out this new capability in your organization. Let's see what you can do. So you have three options. First of all, you can play with licenses. Removing licenses will allow you to avoid that people use this new capability. The second option that you have is using office policies. So if you open as admin config.office.com, you can create a specific policy for this brand new capability. So this is an example. I'm creating a new policy and I name it Copilot Pages. Then the next step is targeting the full tenant or specific groups or departments. It's up to you. I'm targeting everyone in this case. Under policies, which is the next step, you can type Copilot. And this will give you three options at the moment. The one that targets and relates to the Copilot Pages is this one. Create and view loop files in Microsoft 365 Copilot chat. All you need to do is just target this one and then disable it. So you can then publish the policy and this will be disabled in your organization. The third option that you have is using conditional access. Conditional access allows you to avoid that people work with loop files, for example. So these are the three options that you can use to avoid that this capability is immediately available in your organization. Now, let's jump on the Biz Chat. So now Microsoft has renamed the Copilot Chat. When Microsoft refers to Biz Chat, they are referring to this website, m365.cloud.microsoft, and then you have the Copilot icon here. When you click on this one, we are now in the Biz Chat. You have two options here available. This is also depends from the configuration that you set up on your tenant. In my case, I allowed the use of the web tab in the Copilot Chat. So now I can start to work and ask something to Copilot. But let me clarify that edit the page, the Copilot Pages, it's not yet available for the web tab. It seems that the rollout is not fully completed because I'm totally sure that this function will be available in the under the web tab as well. So this means that when you search something on the web, you will have the ability to start and opening and edit a loop page. So let's switch now on the work. So luckily I started before searching something. In the history, you have the ability to reopen existing prompt that you drafted for Copilot. When you have a page already there created previously, you will have an icon here in the upper right corner, open page, and also down below, next to the result that Copilot gives you. So if I click now on Edit in Pages, the page created previously will open again. So now I can start editing this page, allowing me to add the content that I need. So, for example, let's start this to work on this experience by adding, for example, callout. This is quite typical, and I love this component because it helps you to highlight people, for example. Maybe you want to involve people on discussing on this one. So let's add another one. There you go. Now I added two colleagues, and we can start to edit and work together on this file. All right, let me now add some content down below. For example, I can add other components like a bulleted list, for example, task 1, task 2, and so on. So if I need to add more content, what I can do is, this will be available, I guess, in the next days, I can switch across tabs, so I can search something on the web, collect information through Copilot, and then switch back on the work. So this will allow me to add more content. So for example, I want to get information from this one. Add content from this file. And prepare an agenda for next meeting. There we go. Let me now send this one. And now Copilot will generate for me the key points coming from this file, which is in German, but of course Copilot has translated for me in English. I have all key points, and if I want, I can copy this or add this to the page. There we go. I have now added automatically by clicking on Editing Pages, the content related to this page and the result coming from Copilot. Now it's added at the bottom of this page. So I can now see from a different perspective this page, how it looks like. Changing perspective, add elements, got an email by Giuliano because I shared the page that we edited before. Now here I can click on this link to open a new tab in the browser, which will allow me to work better and in a full view mode on this page. So now I can add my content. So this user doesn't have a Copilot license, but as you can see, people works on loop. So this, it's not an impediment of in terms of collaboration. Now, what I can do here as a relevance is pin this page to an existing workspace that I have, for example, loop recurring meetings. Now this new page generated through the new capability Copilot edit pages, it's now added to my workspace. Let me open this, and there we go. This is the link. Help me prepare for loop, and it's here available. So good to know is that every page that you edit using Copilot is dropped in a container which is saved in SharePoint embedded. So there's no SharePoint or OneDrive, everything is on SharePoint embedded. I am back now in the Giuliano view. So another thing to call out here is the ability to go to pages, which seems to be a dedicated section to have a summary of all pages created in the Biz Chat using Copilot. Let me click on it. However, this dropped me on m365.cloud.microsoft, which is the main dashboard for Microsoft 365. So it's not so easy here in the quick access view to display and to understand what are the pages created using the business chat with Copilot. I assume to see in the future a new category called Pages, for example, that summarize better all pages created and give me an history of all my Copilot prompts that I created. Do you like this new feature? Let me know in the comment down below. If you find this video useful, please consider to subscribe and like. I hope to see you next time. Bye.